While the war between Russia and Ukraine lingers on, a key player in this scene, the Bayraktar TB2 drone, has continued to defend Kyiv-backed forces against the relentless Russian aggression, strengthening Turkey's position as the world's largest exporter of military drones. Encouraged by the success stories, several military units across the globe are lining up in their numbers to purchase this deadly autonomous aerial vehicle. Join us in today's video as we explain why and how the Bayraktar TB2 is drawing so much attention. Thanks to the performances of UAVs like the Bayraktar TB2, drones are increasingly becoming a deciding factor in modern warfare, especially due to their low price and potential to hunt down major targets like military tanks and mighty warships. But are they slowly becoming a motivation for countries to engage in combat? Let's find out together. The Bayraktar TB2 is a tactical armed UAV system built by a private Turkish defense company known as Baykar Technologies. This highly sought unmanned warcraft has an operational altitude of 18,000 feet and a maximum flying altitude of 25,000 feet. Equipped with internal sensor fusion, the TB2 can navigate to find and strike targets without the global positioning system or GPS. Furthermore, it features fully automatic takeoff and landing system, meaning it basically doesn't require a runway. And lastly, before we talk about the sales, the Bayraktar TB2 has a maximum flying range of 27,000 hours. Since it was invented in 2014, this medium-altitude, long-endurance drone has clocked over 400,000 hours of operational flight across several combat and surveillance missions. Over time, countries like Ukraine, Qatar, Azerbaijan, and Morocco have added the Bayraktar TB2 to their fleet of ammunition. And just recently in May, Poland joined this fast-growing list of countries that have fallen in love with the TB2, with the Polish Minister of Defense, Mariusz Błaszczak, announcing a deal with Baykar Technologies to purchase 24 Bayraktar TBs. According to reports, the drones will be delivered in 4 batches, and they will include extra perks like anti-tank missiles, SAR radars, simulators, mobile control stations, as well as training and logistics support for a total cost of $270 million. Błaszczak further hailed the Bayraktar TB2, stating that it has proven its worth on the battlefield. Under Turkish law, the Defense Ministry and the Office of the President must give their approval before drones are shipped abroad. And from all known indications, President Tayyip Erdogan was beyond pleased with the drone sale to Poland. Turkey will, for the first time in its history, export drones to a NATO and UE member, Erdogan said, adding that there are currently over 180 Bayraktar TB2 drones in active service across 4 countries, including Turkey. However, other reputable reports suggest that the number of operational TB2s is much higher than what the president reported. Merv Sarin, an Ankara-based defense analyst, believes that the agreement with Poland paves the way for more NATO countries to purchase Turkish drones in the future. With the level of interest shown in this drone by external countries, you've got to wonder if it really does deliver the goods on the battlefield. Bayraktar's war success stories. During Operation Spring Shield, the Turkish military used this drone to great effect, destroying members of a rebel group led by General Khalifa Haftar. It has also been deployed against criminal elements fighting in Armenia. At one time, the United Arab Emirates provided Chinese-made Wing Lung drones to Libyan forces led by Khalifa Haftar, giving them an undue aerial advantage over the less powerful Turkish drone initially supplied to the UN-backed Libyan government. Haftar and his forces deployed these Lung drones at night in Tripoli, killing innocent citizens and children. Seeing the situation, the Turkish government decided to send a couple of Bayraktar TB2s to the UN-recognized Libyan government, and that ultimately changed the face of the war. Using this weapon, men of the Libyan army were able to fight back and defend the country's capital before going on the offensive to evacuate Haftar-led forces from a key airbase in 2020. Over the past half decade, Turkey has continuously sent out Bayraktar TB2s on cross-border combat and surveillance operations. In Syria alone, there have been 3 of such missions, including the Euphrates Shield, Olive Branch, and the Spring Shield. Turkish drones have also been used to deliver lethal aerial strikes against Bashar al-Assad's forces in Syria, taking out more than 100 armored vehicles to halt Assad's assault in the Idlib province. While Turkey-built drones have grown in popularity in recent times, the country is not alone in its pursuit to become a global force in drone technology. Other countries like China, Israel, and the United States hold considerable market shares in the drone industry. Back when Turkey didn't have a drone program, The country depended on Israeli drones to battle Kurdish criminal groups in Syria. It became worse between 2010 and 2012 when the United States refused to sell combat drones to the Turkish government, forcing the latter to look within and develop a drone program of its own. Among the heavyweights in the drone industry, China is considered as the biggest competition to Turkey because, unlike the due diligence process in Israel and the United States, Chinese drones can be bought easily. This has helped to increase the interest in Chinese drones, especially from countries in Africa and the Middle East. In July 2020, China sold six CH-92A attack reconnaissance UAVs to Serbia. The Chinese had hoped that this would boost their entry into the European market and drive more demand for its drones in the region, but that didn't happen. More because the performance in highly sensitive combat situations has not been proven. However, at a unit price of $1 million, countries like Nigeria, Egypt, and the United Arab Emirates, and many others have jumped at the opportunity of buying Chinese combat drones. In Israel's case, demand is somewhat stable, and having executed different missions in Palestine, Lebanon, and Gaza, their competence is not in doubt. But the due diligence process, high cost, and restrictions involved in procuring drones from the country can be tiring for potential customers. Meanwhile, American drones are known to be exceptionally efficient in delivering laser-precise airstrikes, but they're even more expensive than their Israeli counterparts, with one unit of the MQ-9 Reaper costing around $100 million. If you reached this far in the video, we would like to give you a huge thanks. You can extend your support for subscribing to the channel and turning that notification bell on so you don't miss any of the content we upload. Comment down below "I subbed" for your chance to be entered in our monthly shoutout giveaway. In terms of price, Turkish UAVs like the TB2 drones are considered mid-range because they're slightly more expensive than Chinese drones, but way cheaper than those made in Israel and the United States. However, when we rank them based on performance, Turkish drones are just about as good as their Israeli and US counterparts. On average, a typical Bayraktar TB2 drone costs between $1 and $5 million, and the whole world has seen firsthand how effective they've been against the Russian forces, destroying oil storage, tanks, helicopters, and aircraft worth hundreds of millions of dollars. In addition, Bayraktar Technologies offer training and other after-sale support to customers who require them. These three factors combined are the major reasons why the Bayraktar TB2 has gained so much attention in the last few months. Bayraktar TB2 is doing what it is supposed to do, taking out some of the most advanced anti-aircraft systems and advanced artillery systems and armored vehicles. Sukuk Bayraktar, one of Bayraktar's top officials, told Reuters, adding that the whole world is a customer. The Bayraktar has earned special admiration across different military units around the world, so much so that members of the Ukrainian army made a catchy music video in its honor. It's hard to think of any other military equipment that has gotten this type of fanfare and endorsement in recent times. Not even the US Predator or Reaper can boast of this achievement. However, this enormous publicity might have some negative implications to it by creating a situation known as drone envy. For instance, in 2021, Kyrgyzstan purchased three Bayraktar TB2s from Turkey to gain a significant advantage over Tajikistan in the ongoing cross-border dispute. After being on the receiving side for a while, Tajikistan approached Turkey to buy Bayraktar TB2 drones of its own, canceling out its neighbor's advantage. You might argue that the TB2 evened things out between both countries, but on the other hand, it is being used to stoke the fire. Probably a more diplomatic approach could have been adopted if the Bayraktar TB2 wasn't so cheap and accessible as it is. Countries and even private aggressors now know that they can impose their will and wreak havoc on weaker oppositions. End quote. We hear that Baykar is currently designing the TB3, a more lethal version of the TB2 that will have foldable wings. The firm is also looking to design AI-powered aircraft that will revolutionize human transportation. What's your opinion of the use of drones in warfare? Will they eventually become more efficient than military aircraft? Let us know what you think in the comment section down below. Be sure to check out this video over here.